on my morning run, and I gotta say, for like the worst winter ever, like COVID and so cold and lonely, I'm having like the best winter ever. It's a beautiful and crisp and so snowy, and just the clouds, like, can we like go off clouds? Okay, yeah, it's not too bad. It's not great. It's not that bad. Oh yeah. All right, I'm gonna take you with me as I trudge up this little mountain, try to get to my favorite spot. It's a real good sitting spot. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. And I'll show you why. Woo! So, while I'm in this lovely sits spot, I guess I'll talk to you about what I assume this video is going to be about when I put it together. The winter is amazing. As someone who's like always favored summer so much because it's like warm and it's easy to be outside and everything feels alive and shiny and pretty and colorful, and the summer's great for all of those reasons, but the winter has always been something that I was afraid of or like dread, because it was just like everything's cold and dead and the opposite of like the best thing. And I've definitely had winters here in New Paltz where I felt that way, but I think this is maybe the most beautiful winter I've ever experienced, and I'm really glad to say that it's given me a whole new perspective on winter. The air takes on this energy of just unabashed openness in a way that, like, the summer is like sweet. The air is thicker and it's softer. Here, the winter air is just like, gets all up in your nooks and crannies and it like pronounces itself. I think that's a good way to describe the winter. It pronounces itself. It is sharp and it's stark. It's bright in a different kind of way. And instead of looking at the forest and marveling in the soft luminosity of the foliage and how plump with life everything feels in the wintertime, it's like a laser. You can see through a landscape in a way that you've never been able to, because there's all these leaves in the way. But in the winter, you can really trace an entire mountainscape with your eyes and never lose sight of the ground or the sky at any moment. And it helps when there's like incredible swaths of snow just highlighting every beautiful contour of this incredible, incredible earth. Ugh. And can we talk about this blue? Can we talk about this blue? I think part of what makes enjoying this winter in particular so important is acknowledging that there's a lot of stuff going on right now. And a lot of times when I've been feeling really not good, super isolated, not necessarily lonely. I've been lonelier, but there's a loneliness that I know that stings a lot more. This one is just kind of like an acceptance of, like, there are circumstances that are making it difficult to be a person around other people, and that's been really hard because we've been doing it for a long time, way, way, way too long. Yeah, I think part of what makes this winter so magical is because it's forcing me to really look at it. I've been told that I am relentlessly optimistic and that that's not necessarily a good thing. But it sure as hell makes my life a lot easier in times when it sure as hell could be a lot harder. A friend of mine recently said that you're always as strong as you need to be. And she said that really helped her in feeling that she would always have the tools that she would need at her disposal when shit was rough. And I've been thinking about that, like, what is enough? I remember you talking about it too when it comes to money. It's like, yeah, I've always just had enough, you know? It's like, it's not a whole lot, but it gets you by. Every now and then you can get yourself something nice, and strength and happiness are kind of like that too. There's always enough, even in times of scarcity, and you wish there was more. You know. Everything we need is really right here. And I don't want to be all dismissive of, like, really difficult things and not giving them the weight or the space that they deserve. But it is really helpful to know that we have the ability to focus on things that are a little less painful. If you stub your toe and it really hurts in that moment, you can't think about anything else. Yeah. And if you, like, break your heart, or if you are going through some real, real ouchy, painful, soul-crushing stuff, then yeah, that is immediate and very real. But the rest is kind of like, you take the time to let things come over you, to let them wash over you, to visit you when there is space allocated for them. And, you know, let things come up. And I think that's why I like going on these walks so much, just because, like, I don't necessarily have to think that much, but I can just sit here and exist and be like, wow, the way that the sky is doing that thing right there, insane, super cool, yeah. And somehow, when I'm not thinking about what that means or the things that are causing me all the bad feelings, all of a sudden, when I don't feel like I need to think about them, they have room to breathe. And winters like these, moments like these, this is breathing room. This is really important. This is good medicine. Dr. Emma is here to prescribe you a little bit of breathing room, a little bit of space to let your thinky thoughts dissipate into this vast envelope of gas around us. Gosh, it's so pretty. And with that, I will leave you with the rest of some good footage that I took on some winter adventures. Like that day, that was a snow day we had, where we got like a foot of snow. Those are the waterfalls at Sam's Point. Super, super, super beautiful. Yeah, some Babylon Brooks, some cave adventures, all that good stuff. I love you very much. Enjoy the winter.